Hello everybody, hello, welcome to the channel. Today it's a bit of an unboxing. As you remember, last time when I went out on my bike ride, I got up to the eyes in mud. So I get the package in action. And of course, a mudguard, front mudguard for the mountain bike. It's a Zefal, how do you pronounce that? FM30, front mud guard. I've opened the packet up with the cable ties in there. There's a little rubber mount. I think to put the cable ties through, I think maybe it's to stop it marking your bike. And I've also got stickers there as well, so I can put different colour stickers down there. You know, so that if you wanted to, like that, so you can modify it whatever colour you fancy, and a bit on the back here as well. You have that colour on that side. I don't know, I might just leave it black. I don't know, I'll decide when I get on the bike. So yeah, new mud guard, so hopefully that will stop us getting so clarty on the mountain bike. It looks like a good size, like. It looks like a good sturdy mud guard, that. So I'm going to fit that to the mountain bike now. So folks, outside, going to fit it. Got instructions. We colour strip here, which actually, if you look, it actually matches the bike quite well. But I don't think I'm going to put it on. I don't think. I can decide another time. It's going to basically slot through the bottom of the forks there, and that should fit on there with some cable ties. So I shall get into doing that now. So got the new mud guard on there. Oh, what a palaver it was putting it on, mate. What a palaver. Don't think it's a fault of the mud guard, I think it's more fault of me, to be honest with you. There we go, let's see how it goes there. Let's give it a go on the lines. So I'm trying out the Zefal mud guard, see how it goes. See if it's any good, see if it stops us getting up the eyes. I mean, got a few spots on us already, look, but let's see how it goes. I mean, good reviews this mud guard. It looks the part, it seems to fill the wheel up quite well. I mean, before I was getting mud splattered in my face and all sorts, my glasses were covered. So, hopefully this should be better. £14, I think it was, something like that, off eBay. Some of the mud guards, man, the prices are ridiculous. It's like 50 quid in this for a mud guard, like really? Unbelievable. It seems to be like cycling stuff at the moment, it's just skyrocketing prices, but anyway. This is £14 one, a bit of a job putting it on, to be honest with you. I don't think it's the fault of the mud guard. It was more probably me getting it wrong, but you know, you had to get the cable ties the right length and stuff, which is fair enough, because you just cut them off. But they've got a little rubber little mount on them, I don't know if you can see there. I'll stop the bike. Be easy if I stop and show you. And they've got a little rubber, you can see there, little rubber bits that go around inside there, so you put the cable ties inside the rubber to protect your fork and your pain work and stuff. So getting that the right size was a bit of a pain for me anyway. I don't know, maybe you can do it a lot quicker than I can, but it seems okay. I mean, it's not catching anywhere or anything like that, so time will tell. We'll see how it goes. I haven't put the stickers on. You can put different colour stickers on here, on there and there. You know, it's red, I think it was blue and yellow, everything was red, blue and green, I think it was. And you could put these on here and there if you wanted, you know, jazzed it up a bit, but I've just left it black. So yeah, £14, so let's see how it goes. Universal mud guard, apparently fits any mountain bike. Like say 14, 40, I think, or some daft like that for eBay. Gonna try out today on the mud, see how it goes. Tell you what, it's very mild here, very mild. 55 degrees Fahrenheit, according to the crew. But it's a mild wind as well, very warm wind. Very nice. Very unusual for this time of year, I think. Not complaining though. One of the things I got the mud guard for, as well as obviously mud and stuff, is to stop all the stones hitting the bike as well. When I first got the bike, the amount of chippings and stones jumping up and hitting the frame. Yeah, there was loads of clattering and banging going on off the stones hitting the frame, so I'm hoping this mud guard helps stop that as well. Be worth it just for that.
do it. I mean, to be fair, I have been going through more puddles on purpose than I would, you know, I normally avoid some puddles, but I've been purposely going through some like this just to see how it copes. We'll see, when we get further round, see how it goes. I'm not sure, really, if you could call it a success, I don't know. I mean, to be fair, I've gone through a lot more clats and puddles and things than I normally would, just to try it out, the mudguard. But it seems to be holding up okay, it hasn't come off. It's not catching on the wheel, anything like that. You know, it seems okay. It might be stopping a bit more mud, I don't know. I mean, there's the, as you can see there, that's the fresh mud, you can see it's still wet. So I don't know really. I mean, to be honest with you, I think the mudguard should go further down. But that's a long mudguard for some of the ones these days. Some of them only go to like here. Some of them are what they call like face guard, where they're just tiny little small, tiny little bits in here, which is kind of pointless. I don't know what the point of that is. But yeah, I think this could have probably gone down to about there, I'll be honest with you. My last mudguard on my other bike, which won't fit on this one unfortunately, is about here. But even that, you still got the odd splash here and there, but yeah, I suppose it's going to be better than nothing, you know, it's going to help us a little bit. And for £14, you know, it's going to be worth a go, but we'll see when I get back. See how dirty I look when I get back. But yeah, see how we go, eh? Guards, I think I know the sort of the noise out of me brakes. I think it's just the piston sticking out, you know, it's the same kind of principle as a car, isn't it? I mean, these brakes are just a smaller version of car brakes, and car brakes do that, you know, where the piston will stick out a little bit until it kind of retracts itself naturally as you drive along. You might hear it sometimes as you go down a hill on a car. You get the bottom of the hill, sometimes you hear a little bit of a noise for a little while. Just until the piston sort of moves itself back over, moves itself back in, and the pads can move back over, I should say. So I think that's what that was. Because done a couple of times today again, but then short while down the road it's just gone off again. So I think that's where it is. I think it's just a piston on the brakes just kind of sticking a little bit. As it kind of retracts back in, you know, it's not retracting in fast enough, so it's catching a little bit, and then obviously as the wheel's going round, it's kind of hitting the pad a little bit and then pushing the piston back away it should be. I've had it before in cars, you know, like I say, loads of times sometimes the pistons stick out completely and you've got to take the pads of brakes out and, you know, ease the piston back in again and get it clamp and push it back in the piston and ease it off and put releasing fluid on and oils and all sorts of palaver. Hope I don't have to do that on this. Yeah. But I think that's where it is, because it goes off after a short while. So I think it's just naturally going back in again after a little while. Fingers crossed. So, nearly home, only a few miles to go. And as you can see, it's pretty muddy the bike. I mean, some of that's old mud, some of that's new mud. And as you can see, I'm pretty muddy. So, to be honest with you, I mean, I'm a bit surprised it's not kept more mud off us, to be honest with you. Considering you can see, it's quite a big mudguard. It's a smart looking mudguard. I think it looks nice. It's a smart looking thing, I think. I like it. I mean, I'm going to leave it on. And it will help, and of course it does help, obviously, protect your shocks from dirt as well. You know, stops mud getting over your shocks, so it does help with that. And to be fair, I mean, I know I'm going to look right in a mess. But I have gone through a lot more mud than normal. I went through a lot more mud than I did in my last video on purpose and puddles and things. So, you know, some of these will be splash marks as well, you know, rather than mud clots, if you like. Some of it splashes have gone through puddles and stuff. I'm not making an excuse or anything like that, you know what I mean? But £14, I think it's still doing a good job. I still think it's keeping quite a bit of mud off us. Help protect the frame from stones, like I said before, and it's going to help protect the forks. You know, keep these seals in good condition. So it's going to be worth it for that, because the mudguard goes down the back of there. If you can see, but goes down the back. See on the side there, can you see where it goes down? So you know, it's going to help protect the forks there as well. So for £14, you know, I don't think it's bad at all. So yeah, I think it's okay. I think I would recommend them. I think it's a good mudguard. As I say, I got mine off eBay, but shop around. I think they're only about £15 with other places as well. I bought it off eBay because it was free delivery for the £14 rather than paying £15 and then delivery on top. So yeah, Zefal mudguards. Is it F30? I'll put it on the screen here. I can't remember. But yeah, I would say they're worth having. Definitely worth having. Okay, well, thanks for joining us. I shall see you very soon. Take care of yourselves. Bye bye.